I think it's very important to talk to people. And if you're a new business and a young business or even an old business, nothing is better than picking up the phone and talking to people. You know, how many times do things get lost in translation when you're sending emails? And I think that it's very important to be confident in business, not arrogant. You know, confidence is being certain that you're good at what you do, you're brilliant at what you do, and you can deliver what people want.
When I grew up, my dad used to encourage my brother and me to fail. So I would come home from school and sit at the dinner table, and my dad would say, "Kids, what did you fail at this week?" And if I didn't have something to tell him, he would be disappointed. So if we weren't failing enough in our home, it meant we weren't trying new things.
You are responsible for your life. And if you're sitting around waiting on somebody to save you, to fix you, to even help you, you are wasting your time, because only you have the power to take responsibility to move your life forward.
For me, I, at a very rough time in my life, sat down and became very specific about writing down, what am I good at? What do I know how to do? And one of the things on my list was sales, and I've been selling fax machines door to door. And then I said, you know, I wrote down the words, I want to come up with an idea I can send to millions of people, sell to millions of people. So I was very specific. So I would tell these people, what do you want? Take the time to sit with yourself and be specific and ask for it.
I knew that I wanted to change my life. I knew that I didn't want to go down the path that I was going down, because I got scared, and fear is a great motivator.
You want to know what I have learned about myself and what I have learned about every great salesman or entrepreneur I've ever worked with? If you can get in the habit of going through the door without the answer, and our education system tends to make you want to have the answer, if you walk through that door, people are amazingly smart. Once you're in there in hot water, you discover the answer.
I just didn't spend money on myself. I just dumped all the profit back in the business, and we were buying vintage stuff, you know, for years, that it costs $5, $10, $15, $50, and you're selling it for, you know, $100, $200, $1,000. I mean, I've bought things for $8 that I've sold for $1,000, and that's like, that's really good cash flow, right? I didn't know what that word even meant, you know, but it was just like, it looked really good, just like building in the bank.
I have found walking through every door, believing that I'm going to go through the door or jump out the window, I'm going to learn how to fly on the way down. And you want to know, I have always had my best successes. And so I wholeheartedly believe in the belief that all of us have the right to be there. Ask for what we want. We all can be rich. We could all put our dagger in the sand or whatever that thing is called and say, that's me. I'm going for it. What the heck? And I don't think it's a reserved right for anybody. And that attitude has been more responsible for building my business and my career than any other thing.
What inspired me to go into fashion when I was leaving the banking industry was the fact that I knew that I had creative talents. I knew that I wanted to set up my own business because I was no longer enjoying working where I was working, because I didn't go to university. And I noticed that those who had university degrees that were being brought in were being brought in above me, despite the fact that I had moved into the banking proper sector of the bank. So I decided that was the time to move on. I resigned, although the managing director at the time refused to accept my resignation for 3 days. And I told him I was going to come back with the same letter after 3 days. So he was forced to let me go.
I started working out of my apartment with a team of two who helped me turn my concept into a reality around my kitchen table for 2 years. Like most startups, we had to fundraise. I asked a lot of people I knew to invest, including some people who didn't have a tremendous amount of money. So I told them, only invest if you're prepared to lose it. I was so scared. In the end, over 100 people invested. With that money, and a personal investment, we set up an office in Hong Kong for sourcing and production.
What I tell young people starting out, find something that you love. Find people that you want to work with. Find a company whose ethics and values you subscribe to. And what I always say to people, if you are not entirely comfortable with the people that you're working with and how they are behaving, run, do not walk for the exits.
I stopped pretending to myself that I was anything other than what I was and began to direct all my energy into finishing the only work that mattered to me. I was set free because my greatest fear had been realized and I was still alive and I still had a daughter whom I adored and I had an old typewriter and a big idea. And so rock bottom became the solid foundation on which I rebuilt my life. It is impossible to live without failing at something, unless you live so cautiously that you might as well not have lived at all.